Welcome to the Math 1 lesson summary video for the task Don't Break the Chain. A solidify understanding task. So if you look with me at the top in purple, the purpose of this task is to reinforce that geometric sequences have a constant ratio, commonly called R, and to allow practice with a real-world scenario of a geometric sequence. So again, that constant ratio is commonly referred to as R, and there'll be another video linked on this same page if you want to learn more about that after this video. So we got this email in the task. I trust that you've read it already from your module. So Bill here is sending out a chain email, which I personally am just not a big fan of chain emails, but that's okay. He's got to do what he's got to do for his business. So in his email, he's sending a letter asking everyone he sent it to send it to 10 more people. So if we read down further, what's highlighted here in yellow is the key. It says on day one, Bill starts by sending the email out to 8 of his closest friends. So, I mean, he's asking us to send it to 10 people, but he could only send it to 8. Come on, Bill. I'm just kidding. But they each forward it to 10 people so that on day two, it's received by 80 people. And then we assume that from there, the chain continues unbroken with everyone sending it to 10 more people. So just taking that information that we get from that sentence that's highlighted, I've created a table down here. And the questions that were asked are, on day 7, how many people will receive the email? And on day N, how many people will receive the email? So let's just keep it going here. So we have 8 people on day 1, 80 on day 2, 800 on day 3, 8,000 on day 4, 80,000 on day 5, I'm just multiplying by 10 every time, 800,000 on day 6, and then 8 million on day 7. So we've already answered this question by using our table, 8 million. And so let's kind of talk about, because this is what they get into later, what type of thinking am I using to fill in this table? I'm using recursive thinking. So we can create a recursive formula for this situation. So we have f of n, the next number in the table, I got by taking the previous number represented by f of n minus 1 and multiplying by 10. And where did we start? We started at f of 1 equals 8. And so in order to answer the day n question, what we really need to do is come up with an explicit formula. So let's think about breaking down the numbers that we got from the recursive formula. So I started with 8, and then I had 80, which was 8 times 10. And then I had 800, which was 8 times 10, the previous one, times 10 again. And then I take those three things and bring them down, 8 times 10 times 10, and I multiply that by 10. And so I take that and I do times 10 again, and this time I'm going to start to kind of break down another way of writing that. So I have 10 times 10 times 10 times 10, or if I want to think about that, that's 8 times 10 to the fourth power. So to find the number of people who emailed on the fifth day, I'm doing the 8 who started times 10 to the fourth power, because we've multiplied by 10 four times, representing each of the days after day 1 to get to day 5. Similarly, if I continue the next one, it would be 8 times 10 to the fifth power. So notice that on day 6 here, it's 5 here. So an explicit rule for this situation, we know we're starting at 8, we're multiplying by 10, this would have to be n minus 1, because the exponent on the 10 every time, this one would be 10 to the 6th, is 1 less than the day number. So 6 is 1 less than 7. And so we can see that that formula works for the entire table. So to answer the question of day n, we have this explicit formula right here. F of n equals 8 times 10 to the n minus 1. So if we look back at the wording of problem 2, it asks us to explain our answer with as many representations as possible. And we've already created a table, a recursive rule, and an explicit rule. So the next logical thing to do would be to make a graph. And I've pulled up desmos.com in order to enable us to do that. So you can type in your explicit rule in slot 1 here using the same notation that we used in the task, f of n equals 8 times 10 to the n minus 1. Notice you have to put in parentheses in order for the n minus 1 to correctly stay in the exponent. But this can create some errors in Desmos if we use this kind of notation. So typically, I find it more helpful to use y and x whenever graphing in Desmos. So I'll type y equals 8 times 10 to the n minus 1. Sorry, to the x minus 1. And we get this graph which pops up. It's helpful to adjust our settings to make sense with what we looked at in the task. So we looked at 0 days up to 7 days, but it's okay for us to go up to 10 to get a more full picture. And we started with 0 emails and we got all the way up to 8 million emails. So we can make our Y maximum here to be 8 million. And now we get a nice picture of this graph and we can see the way that a geometric sequence and its growth looks on a graph. And this is called exponential growth, which we'll talk much more about in the next module. So a nice thing with Desmos is we can quickly convert this table, this graph to a table. So click on settings, click on duplicate, click on convert to table. And we can use this if we input the same values. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, day 6 and day 7 to check the table that we generated. We do see that we get the same thing. And so the third question that's asked in the task is, if Bill gives $4.95 to every person who gets the email and comes in and buys this promotion, how much money will he lose? So we need to add up each of these numbers. We need to add this 8 with this 80 with this 800, 8,000, 80,000, 800,000, and 8 million. And when we do that, we get 8,888,888 people coming in, each one spending $4.95. So Bill is going to spend a whopping $43,999,995.60 on this promotion, so almost $44 million. So I would advise Bill to change it to a BOGO promotion so that if his profit margins are high enough, at least he's going to be making some money off all these people that are coming to his ice cream shop. He's also going to need a really big ice cream shop. Thanks so much for watching. I hope this was helpful. If you need help specifically with the Ready, Set, Go homeworks, remember to check the student support site in Canvas for aligned videos with each RSG section.